So I showed you the eyelash comb. It actually comes in a set. They fold for travel. I paid like $5 on Amazon. Of course, this little side eyelash curler. I have no idea how I lived without this. It curls every hair. Soap brows for makeup revolution. Game changer. The flawless brush. The name says everything. And this right here gives you a perfect cut crease in like 2 seconds.
Snap your fingers, three-step. You can do it all by yourself. Baby girl, what's your name? Let me talk to you, let me buy you a drink.
How to pose your face like a model.
Every day we use our facial muscles to make expressions. This is my face totally relaxed. Pose my face, I lift my brows up, but not too much. Just lift your brows a little bit so your eyes look lifted. One time at a photo shoot, I actually saw a model do this with her lip to create a little more volume in her upper lip. Just make sure you don't do it too much or else you're gonna look like a duck. You can inhale to make your nose appear slimmer, but don't overdo it. Just subtle, like this. A trick to make your neck appear slimmer, you can bring your chin forward towards the camera, like this. It feels super awkward when you're doing it. I mean, look what I look like from the side. My chin is completely forward. But from the front, you would never know. If you're posing from the side, move your jaw towards the camera to create a more sharp and defined jawline like this. Again, it's gonna feel really awkward. Look what I look like from the front. But from the side, you never know. Let me know if you want a part two.
This works like a charm, I promise. This simple egg membrane trick can help you tighten your under eye area in literally weeks. You get rid of eye wrinkles and soften your skin, so try it and let me know if you like it.
Eyeshadow trick that will make your eyes look more lifted. Start by taking a medium fluffy brush in a medium brown and placing it on the highest point of your crease and just start to tap. You want the most intense part to be on the highest point of the crease and then just start to go in circular motions to diffuse that eyeshadow. Apply some mascara, some lashes, and this trick will make your eyes look more awake and give you a quick lift to the eye.
It be the booty for me, the booty for she a little cuter than me. She might not do it for you, little nigga, but she finna do it for me.
Underrated beauty products you didn't know you needed, part two. Leading the pack, we have this sponge that is actually from Makeup Eraser. This launched a couple of months ago or so. This sponge is fantastic, and I hate to say it, but it is 10 times better than the Beauty Blender sponge. It actually comes with this little ball thing that you can toss the sponge in and you can put it in your washer. Yes, it is machine washable. How cool is that? Next up from IT Cosmetics, we have this foundation right here. This is the Your Skin But Better Foundation with Skincare. This is the foundation I have on right now. I have worn this all day, 8+ hours. It has not budged. It is lightweight, but gives your skin a beautiful luminous finish. Oh my goodness, I honestly cannot believe that more people are not talking about this. It is hands down one of the best foundations I have tried recently. The Glow Skin Beauty Precise Micro Brow Liner is hands down the best brow pencil on the market. And then last but not least, the Makeup Forever Artist Color Pencils. These are safe for the lips and the eyes. They are bomb. Follow for more.
How to apply fragrance 101 for girls. One behind each ear, then your hair, because that will make your fragrance stick for more. 4, 5, 6 on your wrist and press it. Or do this.
If you're struggling with your makeup because you got oily or combo skin, this video's for you. The two major issues we're seeing with oily skin, oil and shine control throughout the day, and emphasis on large pores. Step one, get yourself a mattifying, hydrating serum. Contrary to popular belief, oily skin needs hydration too. This is the Neutrogena Matte Shine Control Serum. This has rice protein in it, which helps absorb oil. This step is very important. Grab an oil-free moisturizer. This one's from Kate Somerville. And grab some azelaic acid. This one's from The Ordinary. Azelaic acid is to help with brightness and texture. However, it does a fantastic job of neutralizing oils. Just trust me. Put some moisturizer. Put some azelaic acid. Mix. Let that sit for a solid 3 minutes. Then go in with your sunscreen. Now go in with your actual primer. You can go in with a shine and pore control primer like NARS or Dr. Brandt. Or you can go in with a silicone type of primer like Benefit or Smashbox. You're gonna look matte. You're gonna look poreless. Just trust me.
Do you do your concealer like this and you find it's dragging your face down? Let me show you how to help with that. The reason I'm not a fan of the triangle shape under the eye is because it emphasizes the lowest point of the cheek way too much, in my opinion. So I'm going to show you my preferred method, and also the benefit of this one is that it lifts the face. This is a shape I want you to try. The reason I take it onto the side of the nose is that it gives the nose a natural contour. So I'm going to blend this out and show you the difference. So as you can see, there is a clear difference. This eye is much more lifted and the highlight isn't on the main focal point of the cheek. Whereas this one here, while yes, everything's covered and everything, the highlight is right here. There is a lot of product sitting right on the cheek as opposed to under the eye and lifting the face. Try this out and let me know how you go.
Do you have blackheads, small bumps, uneven skin tone, or oily skin? I've got a one ingredient mask that will transform your skin in less than 30 minutes. All you're going to need is one egg. First, separate the egg white and the egg yolk. Then beat the egg white until it's nice and frothy. Once you see these white bubbles, it's ready. Apply the bubbles on a clean face and wait for it to dry. Egg whites help oily skin, brighten your skin, tighten your skin, combat blackheads, and diminish pores. Once it's dry, rinse it off, and then apply the egg yolk. Egg yolk is actually a natural moisturizer. I prick it open, apply it all over my face, and once it's dry, I rinse it off and like to retighten my pores with a quick ice facial. I do this once a week, and it's amazing.
If you are just getting into beauty, this is the number one thing you should know. Know your correct skin type. Wash your face and don't put anything on it. After an hour, if your face feels tight and uncomfortable, you are dry. If your face is shiny everywhere, you are oily. And if you are only partially shiny and dry in some places, you are combination.
5 life-changing beauty hacks I think every girl should know. Number 1, if you hate getting that white cast when you put SPF on, instead of using your fingers, try using a beauty blender. I learned this on TikTok and it was so life-changing. Number two, if you want to make it look like your lips are just a little bit bigger, contour it with a contour stick, blend it with a beauty blender, and don't forget to clean it up with a concealer. Number three, instead of buying a lipstick, buy the refill. It's a little bit more affordable and a lot of higher end makeup brands will offer this online. And it's so small and mini to put in your bag. Number four is to use your lip balm as cuticle treatment. It makes your manicure last just a little bit longer and look way better. Here's a before and here's an after. And finally, whether it's for a special occasion or every day, try putting your lashes on underneath the lash line. This is going to look like a lash extension. Just make sure that you put a thin layer of glue and it dries tacky before you apply. Share this with a friend who needs it. Thanks for watching. Follow for more.
Top 5 drugstore makeup products.
Elf Camo Concealer is $6 and super full coverage. Revlon Untold Stories, the best drugstore nude. Salon Perfect 614s, best lash ever. CoverGirl Micro Brow Pencil, better than Anastasia. Maybelline Lifter Gloss for the juiciest lips.
I'm going to show you how to get pretty looking eyes in 3 easy steps. Pro tip, you were born with pretty eyes, we're just enhancing them. Step 1, you're going to need a medium brown eyeshadow in a creamy formula. Here are 3 different options for different skin tones, but you can really go with whatever you like. You're gonna take your shadow and a fluffy brush and you're gonna tap it in. We're going right onto the lids. You're gonna keep blending until you like the way it looks, keep building the intensity, and then make sure there's no harsh lines. Make sure you take the same color on the lower lash line. Look at the difference. So we're lining the upper inner waterline of the inner corner and then the lower inner waterline of the inner corner. Then we're taking the same idea and we're repeating it on the outer corner of our eyes, keeping it on the outer third. This trick gives you a more sultry eye look, but it doesn't make your eyes look smaller. Lash curler, this is very important. I'm finishing the eyes with a coat of mascara. That's it. That's how I get pretty eyes in 3 easy steps. Click like and follow for more.
I would have stayed at home, 'cause I was doing better alone, but when you said hello, I know that was the end of it all. I should have stayed.
How I make my legs look good in a mini skirt. Skirt, skirt. So first I exfoliate, I'm using matcha scrub. Then I shave my legs using Cocoa Cloud, the only cream that has ever helped me prevent razor bumps. Finally, the secret sauce. Yes, it is a butt serum, but who doesn't want their legs to be tight and glowing too?
How to create a French girl red lip. After doing some research, I noticed a lot of French girls will mix a brighter red with a deeper purple, and they'll apply it with their finger so that it's a lot softer. You don't need to be too precise. And then rather than liner, go in with a Q-tip to clean up the outsides, and that's going to give you a really diffused, natural look. Follow for more tips.
How to remove makeup by a dermatology nurse practitioner. No. 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 Yes. Yes. Yes.
So I'm about to change so many lives right now. This stuff is called anti-monkey butt. It's an anti-friction powder. I know the name is ridiculous, but trust me on this. If you like get sweaty between your boobs or you don't have the thigh gap and you got some like friction going on, wherever you're sweating, okay? And don't act like it don't happen. My boobs never sweat anymore. It's amazing. But the last thing I want is this sitting out on my counter in my bathroom and people seeing it. So I got this cute little thing. Way easier application, by the way. So we're just gonna put it in this cute little container. And nobody is going to know. How will they know? Nobody is going to know.
Beauty tricks every girl should know. Soak your beauty blender completely, then squeeze out the water. It will give you an even and smooth finish. Use your brow pencil to line your nose, then blend upward to create the perfect contour. Add bronzer under your bottom lip to create an illusion of bigger lips. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram.
Oh no, I ran out of my favorite kind of leave-in conditioner. So snip it like that ex-husband, because 3 is enough, and let's see what's inside. Oh my goodness, there's so much left in there. Let's scoop it out and actually see how much there is. I put it inside these little containers I get from the dollar store. Like, literally, I had enough to fill it, and there was still more in the cap. So I'm going to take the excess that was in the cap of it and just kind of scrunch it through my hair. I love that it, like, smooths the texture of my skin. Also helps to fight against humidity and really good for those tricky flyaways. And obviously, put some in your beard. You're welcome.
Guys, OMG, finally, here is an easy way to nose contour. One pack on the bronzer. Two, line of concealer, then blend.
Show me the life hack that you randomly saw one day that is now an unconscious standard practice in your life. I'll go first.
Tips from a former beauty queen, where I share the tricks I learned during my reign as Miss Arkansas. Let's start with fake eyelashes. If you're having trouble hiding the strip, add black eyeshadow over the band before applying them to your eyes. This will help them appear more natural and blend in with your eyeliner.
Here's the coolest trick I've ever learned from Dr. Dennis Gross on how to know which ingredient to use under your eyes to help with dark circles. What you're going to do is going to look a little freaky. Slightly pull the under eyes up a little bit to see if the darkness disappears or not. If it does, that means your skin is thin and the purple veins are showing through, so you want something to help with building collagen like vitamin C. If the color stays, that means your skin is discolored and you want an ingredient like retinol to help resurface and brighten the skin.
I'm the hottest, you ain't never gotta heat me up. I'm present when I'm absent, speaking when I'm not there. Call them bitches scary cats, I call them Carol Baskin. Body, yaddy, 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 yaddy. Body, yaddy, 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 yaddy. Body crazy, curvy, wavy, big titties, lil' waist. Body crazy, curvy, wavy, big titties, lil' waist. Body, yaddy, 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 yaddy. I'm a hot ebony, they gon' click.
My top makeup tricks for fuller looking lips.
Step one, I love to exfoliate my lips with this lip scrub from KNC Beauty. It helps bring circulation to your lips, which makes them look more plump, and it also buffs away all the dead skin cells. For the next step, I like to use a lip liner just one shade darker than my natural lip color, and I overdraw my lips. I'm loving this one from Kevin Aquan. The shade is called Divine. Another trick of mine is to fill in the natural wrinkles on your lips. I think this just makes them look even more full. Next, I'm just going to apply a lip tint. This is from Nude Sticks, and the color is called Beach Babe. I think this is the perfect color if you're going for that 90s nude lip. Now, this is one of my favorite tricks for making your lips look full. I'm going to apply this highlighter from Surratt. The shade is called Diamante, just in the center of my lips and across my Cupid's bow to really make my lips pop and look more full. This is my last trick. I'm going to use a bronzer to make a fake shadow underneath my bottom lip. The key is that you want it to look like your lips are so big that they're casting a shadow. And that's it for my full lip routine. Hope you enjoyed.
You know how the Jade Roller like chisels out your cheeks because of the lymphatic drainage? Well, I am supposed to be in a wedding in 25 minutes and this barely zips up at my waist. So no joke, you guys, I might be crazy. I'm hoping that this works on my waistline. So I have been sitting doing this. Am I a total idiot? I'm a total idiot.
Someone sent me this on Instagram, so I figured I'd give it a try to see if it helps my drooping eyebrow. I guess you hold your eyebrow up and rub top of your forehead really hard. Not sure, but whoa, do you guys see that lift? That is crazy.
Hennessy on my lips, take a little sip, privacy on the door, I'ma make this shit work.